NMR spectroscopy unit 3. In this unit we are studying about chemical shift, factors influencing the chemical shift and applications of NMR. Chemical shift is defined as the difference in parts per million between the resonance frequency of the observed proton and tetramethylsilane hydrogens. Here, tetramethylsilane is the most common reference compound used in NMR. It is used in NMR as a reference standard because it is delta value is set as 0 parts per million. So regarding this TMS, we will study in detail in the next coming slides. And chemical shift can be calculated by using this formula, that is delta is equal to frequency of the signal produced for the given proton minus frequency of reference divided by spectrophotometer frequency. So it is expressed as parts per million. Almost all hydrogen absorptions occurs downfield within 10 parts per million of with reference to tetramethylsilane. For C13 NMR, almost all absorptions occurs within 220 parts per million downfield of the carbon atom in TMS. What is delta scale? Delta scale, so in the NMR spectra, it is displayed as a plot of the applied radio frequency versus the absorption. So the applied frequency increases from left to right. So the left side of the plot is the low field, that is downfield, or it is also called as deshielded one. And the right side of the plot is the high field, it is upfield or shielded side. And this is called as delta scale. The position on the plot at which the nuclei absorbs is called the chemical shift, and since this has an arbitrary value, a standard reference point must be used. So the two most common standards used here are tetramethylsilane, which has been assigned as a chemical shift of 0, and deuterochloroform, so which has a chemical shift of 7.26 for proton NMR and 77 for C13 NMR. So here shielding protons and deshielding protons will show the absorption towards different fields. See, if the protons are deshielding, then high electron density around the nucleus shields the nucleus from the external magnetic field, so the signals are upfield in the NMR spectrum. In case if lower electron density around a nucleus, that deshields the nucleus from the external magnetic field and the signals are downfield in the NMR spectrum. Now let us see about internal standard. The internal standard used in NMR spectroscopy is tetramethylsilane. It is generally employed as a standard for measuring the position of either proton NMR or C13 NMR spectroscopy. So this has been used as a reference standard because of these reasons. That is, it is chemically inert and miscible with a large range of solvents. It will not react with the chemical which we are subjecting it for the analysis. That is, it is chemically inert and it is miscible with a large range of solvents. It is completely miscible with the solvents, and its 12 protons are all magnetically equivalent. All 12 protons which it contains are magnetically equivalent. So as a result of that, it produces only one single strong peak. And it is highly volatile. It is having 27 degrees centigrade is the boiling point. So it is highly volatile and it can be easily removed to get back the sample. In case if the sample is highly precious, if we want to recover back the sample, so it can be done. Why? Because the internal standard which is used here will be no more. It will be evaporating during the time of during the process of measurement. And so whatever the sample we are subjecting it for the analysis, it will be free in the pure form. So we can even get it back, this we can get back, we can isolate back the sample. It is all because of the high volatility of the tetramethyl silane. It gets evaporated at 27 degrees centigrade. And it does not take part in the intermolecular association with the sample. And its resonance position is far away from the absorptions due to protons in the molecule. So, because of this reason, it is the delta value assigned for this TMS is zero. A scale can be devised in which most of the protons' resonances are of the same sign. So, here the silicon which is present at the center is less electronegative than the carbon. So, it gives a strong single peak because of equivalent hydrogen atoms. So, tetramethyl silane is the structure wherein which at the center there is a silane atom surrounding which four methyl groups are attached. Four methyl groups are attached to this silane atom. So when compared to carbon atoms, this silane is having less electronegative. So it is less electronegative than that of carbon. So as a result of that, it gives a strong single peak because of equivalent hydrogen atoms which are present on it. Next, we'll see the factors influencing the chemical shift. What are the factors which are affecting the chemical shift? So these are the factors which are affecting the chemical shift, that is inductive effect, van der Waals shielding, van der Waals deshielding, anisotropic effect and hydrogen bonding. Now let us see one by one. Inductive effect. Inductive effect means development of polarity, that is the presence of an electronegative atom or electronegative group in an atom that deshields the proton. As the electronegativity of the atom increases, the deshielding effect in the proton also increases. So as a result of that, the delta value also increases. For example, let us see by taking an examples and by comparing the delta values here. CH3CH3 and CH3I, that is let us see the example, that is CH3CH3 and CH3F. In these two structures, when you see, there are three types of atoms which are present. One is carbon, other one is hydrogen and fluorine. When you together consider these two molecules, you please write the structure of CH3CH3 and CH3F separately. The bond between carbon and hydrogen and carbon and hydrogen and carbon and fluorine. So totally here we see three types of atoms which are present. So the electronegativity of hydrogen is 2.2 and the electronegativity of carbon is 2.55, whereas fluorine is 4. So the electronegativity of hydrogen is 2.2 and carbon is 2.5, fluorine is 4. That means the electronegativity of carbon is lesser than that of fluorine, whereas hydrogen is still lesser. So now we are studying the absorption of protein. So the effect of the other highly electronegative atoms which are attached to this proton we are referring. And when the hydrogen which is attached to only carbon, then the electronegativity will be, the effect of electronegativity will be lesser when the hydrogen which is attached to the carbon bearing the fluorine. When the hydrogen atom which is attached to a carbon which is bearing the fluorine. So what happens here is that when only carbon is directly attached to, when hydrogen is directly attached to carbon, the electronegativity which is acting on it will be lesser when compared to the carbon which is attached to the hydrogen which is attached to a carbon which is bearing fluorine. Why? Because the carbon is having less electronegativity than that of fluorine. So because the fluorine is having high electronegativity and it will be trying to pull the electrons towards it, as a result of that the electron density will be moving towards fluorine, so that the hydrogen which is attached to carbon will be having lesser density towards it, lesser density of electrons towards it when compared to alkane, that is when compared to butane. In case of butane, there is no fluorine, only carbon atoms which are attached to hydrogen. So as a result of that, what happens? The shielding is more in case of butane. So on the proton, the electron density when compared with that of carbon, so the we observe the in case of butane, the shielding is more. So because the shielding is more, the delta value is less. And as the hydrogen atom is being replaced by the iodine, the delta value is going on increasing. The reason behind is that as the electronegativity of the atom increases, it gets deshielded. The proton gets deshielded because this electronegative atom is trying to pull the electron towards it. As a result of that, the electron density towards the hydrogen decreases. So this depends upon the electronegativity of the atom which is attached to a carbon bearing hydrogen. So as the electronegativity of the ion increases, the atom increases, the hydrogen is getting deshielded. As the electronegativity increases, the deshielding effect on the hydrogen will be more. So CH3F is completely deshielded. That means it requires higher energy to absorb. That is why it is showing the delta value 4.3. Whereas alkane, that is butane, which is not deshielded when compared to methyl fluorine. So that is why it is shielded. So the protons which are present here are absorbing lesser energy. That is why it is having the delta value is 0.9. So when deshielding is there, when there is a deshielding, it will absorb higher energy. When there is shielding, it will absorb lesser energy. So that is what is the inductive effect. Next is van der Waals deshielding. This happens due to steric hindrance. That is, when the bulkier groups are nearby, they get deshielded. And as a result of that, the delta value will be more. So due to the electrostatic repulsion, this deshielding happens. So here, when the electron cloud of bulky groups will tend to repel the electron cloud which is surrounding the proton in such a way that the proton will be deshielded and it will resonate at the higher delta value. It requires higher delta value to undergo from alpha state to beta state. Next we'll see magnetic anisotropy, where the pi electrons effect. So here we can observe the stronger in one direction and the electrons will be weaker in the other directions. So that is due to the presence of the uneven distribution of these electrons, the chemical bond will be stronger at one direction and weaker at the other direction. So due to this, the stronger and weaker condition the anisotropy exists. So here the chemical shift of nearby nuclei depends upon the nucleus with respect to the bond. So we can see here in the benzene there is a pi molecular orbital. As we know, in the pi molecular orbital the pi electrons will be keep moving, so it will be keep circulating in the pi molecular orbital. So as a result of that, it creates a ring current, and the hydrogen atoms which are attached to the carbon here are having the induced magnetic field, and it will reinforce the external magnetic field. So near the protons, so that because of that reason these are deshielded. We'll see by taking another examples. So here the proton type, let us consider the proton which is present in benzene and the proton which is present, which is attached to a alkene, alkyne, and to the ketone group, that is in the aldehyde group, to which is attached to CO. In case of hydrogen in benzene, it is highly deshielded. So it is highly deshielded. As a result of that, the chemical shift will be lying from 6.5 to 8. It is highly deshielded because of pi molecular orbitals which are forming a ring current, and it is just in the last slide we have studied that it is the induced magnetic field is reinforces the external magnetic field, so that the near protons which are deshielded here. So it will be highly deshielded. Because of that, we are getting the delta value 6.5 to 8, in that range of 6.5 to 8. Whereas the protons which are attached to alkene are just deshielded comparatively, compared to protons which are present in benzene. So these are less deshielded. So we can say that it is just deshielded. So it will have the delta value of 4.5 to 6. In that range we will have the delta values. Whereas if the proton which is attached to alkyne, then compared to alkane, this is less deshielded. That you can say that it is shielded. It is shielded. That means the electron density towards proton is reduced because of the presence of carbon-carbon pi molecular electrons, this pi electrons. So these pi electrons will be reinforcing the magnetic field. So as a result of that, it will be shielded. So the value of delta value will be here 2.5. And in case of aldehyde, the proton which is attached in aldehyde will be very highly deshielded. Why? Because the carbon bearing the proton is attached to electronegative atom. So this will be trying to pull the electron towards it. As a result of that, the electron density towards proton will be completely very less. So as a result of that, it is the proton which is attached to a carbon bearing the highly electronegative atom in aldehyde, it is very highly deshielded. So it requires higher energy to, it will absorb higher energy to convert from alpha state to beta state. So that is why we are observing here the delta values will be ranging from 9 to 10. Next is hydrogen bonding. So in the hydrogen bonding, the protons which are involved in the hydrogen bonding are usually observed over a wide range of chemical shift. So what is hydrogen bonding? As we know that hydrogen bonding is a bonding between two highly electronegative atoms. That is, wherein which this hydrogen atom acts as a bridge between these two highly electronegative atoms. With one highly electronegative atom, it forms a strong covalent bond, and with the other highly electronegative atom, it will just have a force of attraction. So as a result of that, both the sides there are highly electronegative atoms. Though these highly electronegative atoms will be trying to pull the electrons towards it, as a result of that, the electron density on this proton will be very, very less. So it will be it will be deshielded. The proton will be deshielded because of the hydrogen bonding. So a wide range of hydrogen bonds strengths and consequently a wide range of deshielding effect we observe here. This is as well as a solvation effect also it causes. So the acidity, concentration and temperature makes it very difficult to predict the chemical shift for these atoms. And these are the applications of NMR spectroscopy. The NMR spectroscopy is applied in various fields, that is pharmaceutical analysis, structural confirmation of the drugs, and in the medicine field, and for non-destructive testing, and for the acquisition of dynamic information, and petroleum industry, and flow probes, quantum computing, and magnetometers, it has been applicable. And even in the pharmaceutical analysis, it is used for the identification testing, assay of drugs, and quantitative analysis for the determination of structure, it is applied. And in case of medicine, the application for of this NMR is best known to the general public is that the magnetic resonance imaging for medical diagnosis, for MRI, it will be used. So the magnetic resonance microscopy in the research settings will be used, and chemical studies also, it will, for the study of chemicals, it will be used in the body. So non-destructive testing, nuclear magnetic resonance is extremely useful for analyzing samples non-destructively, and radio waves and static magnetic fields easily penetrate many types of matters and anything that is not inherently ferromagnetic. So these are the various applications of NMR spectroscopy, and this also makes a nuclear magnetic resonance a good choice for analyzing dangerous samples.